Now, sports with Pete Byrne.
One bad game is a head scratcher. Two in a row, that's major cause for concern. For the second consecutive week, Notre Dame is its own worst enemy as the Irish throw away a game against Northwestern today. Everett Golson under the microscope all week long following his 5-turnover performance against Arizona State. He wasn't perfect today, but the good definitely outweighed the bad for number 5. This is just the 4th play from scrimmage. He finds a seam on the option read and goes 61 yards for the touchdown. Irish up 7-0. After Northwestern tied it up, the Irish defense makes a huge play. Cody Riggs strips the football, and the captain, Austin Collinsworth, scoops it up and returns it 32 yards for a touchdown. That was Collinsworth's first play back since getting injured 5 weeks ago. And it should have put the Irish up by 7, but their special teams woes continue here. Malik Zaire, the new holder, but bobbles the snap. The extra point gets blocked, and Northwestern returns it all the way back for a safety. Instead of a 14-7 game, it's now 13-9. And from this point on, Northwestern had life, the Irish wasting several opportunities to squash it. Up 5 in the 4th quarter, about to score. Chris Brown fumbles on the goal line. Notre Dame's 2nd red zone turnover of the game cost them a shot to take a 2-possession lead. 2 plays later, Cole Loop bails them out as he picks off the pass near midfield and set up the Irish with great field position. After that play, Everett Golson hits Will Fuller. Fuller's going to take it in for his 3rd touchdown of the game. He had a phenomenal day. Irish back up 2 possessions. Now, Brian Kelly likes to go for 2 here. Didn't need to, but he does. Everett Golson flushed out of the pocket. Pass is incomplete, so the Irish lead is 11, not 12. Why is that significant? Because Northwestern's going to score again with 4 minutes to go. They would convert their 2-point conversion, and now, instead of needing a touchdown, they can tie the game with a field goal. It still shouldn't have mattered. Irish looking to run out the clock when Cam McDaniel is stripped. Northwestern recovers just over a minute to go, but they have life. And after marching into field goal range, Jack Mitchell boots one from 45 yards. Northwestern rallies from 11 down in the final minutes to force overtime. Irish get the ball first in OT. Can't score. Another poor hold, and Kyle Brinz's field goal attempt is wide left. He missed 2 field goals today, plus the extra point. And that means all Northwestern needs is another field goal, and Mitchell is right down the middle. Much like they did in their last meeting 19 years ago, Northwestern comes into town today and shocks the Fighting Irish. The final score today, 43-40 in overtime. Notre Dame commits 4 turnovers of the game, misses 2 field goals and an extra point. And for the first time since 2011, the Irish have lost consecutive football games. Adam